In this video, I'm going to show you how I used a Raspberry Pi to create those time-lapse videos you saw in the intro. So inside here is a Raspberry Pi, and essentially what it is a mini computer. It runs off of 5 volts and has all of the standard computer features, but what I'm going to use it as is a controller for my 3D printer. The main reason anyone would want to do this is to add features to a printer, such as wireless control, additional safety features, and the ability to monitor the print from anywhere. But what I'm interested in is a plugin called Octolapse, which allows me to create those really cool time-lapse videos. Normally, when I make a print time-lapse, I just set the camera up here and set it to take a picture once every minute. And then once the print is done, I just compile all of those pictures into a video to get something like this. Now, one of the problems in doing this is this bed moves back and forth, so sometimes the picture's taken when it's up here, and sometimes it's taken when it's all the way back here. And when you put all that in a video, it kind of jumps back and forth, and it can be really unpleasant to watch. Essentially, what Octolapse does is sync the printer and the camera together. So basically, the printer prints like normal, but every time it moves up a layer, it'll move the nozzle to a certain position, usually out of the way, and it'll take a picture, and then it'll go back to printing. It'll do that for every layer, and then when we're done, I'll have a bunch of pictures that were taken in the same horizontal coordinates, so that way the print doesn't move in the time-lapse video. The setup process is long and a little bit tedious, so I'm not going to go into too much depth on what I'm doing, but if you're interested in doing this yourself, I've linked the whole 45-minute long tutorial that I found the most helpful in the video description. Essentially, what I have to do is write the program to the SD card, modify a couple of settings, and then I have to install the plugin. To do this, I'm going to need two programs. The first one is an etcher, which allows me to properly write to the SD card, and the second one is Notepad++, which allows me to properly edit the settings. Once everything was set up, I tried my very first print. Everything was set up very temporarily in case I needed to make adjustments later. I just sliced a test cube in Cura and uploaded the G-code to Octoprint, and this is the very first time lapse. When I originally set this up, I didn't change the camera settings, so it defaulted to that low resolution. I set the stabilization to orbit, which is why the nozzle does little circles around the print. One thing I forgot to do was focus the camera, so that's why it's a bit blurry, but as you can see, it definitely works. Next, I tried printing a benchy boat. So one of the obvious issues with moving the nozzle out of the way every time the layer changes is that it's at a higher risk of hitting something and causing a print failure. So to fix this, I enabled Z-Hop. So now instead of the nozzle just moving side to side, it also moves up a little bit so it doesn't hit anything. Missing someone. At this time, everything was still just sitting on top of the desk, so I figured I should print a case for the Raspberry Pi. This case I printed has two parts. The Raspberry Pi is secured to the base, and then the lid is screwed on top. By the way, all of the models I use in this video are on Thingiverse, and I've linked them in the video description. So now the Raspberry Pi is protected, but the camera is still just taped to a box. So the next thing to do is to print an arm for the camera. What a wonderful world. In order to use the camera arm, I need a longer ribbon cable. So while I was waiting for that to arrive in the mail, I decided to print a minifigure of the Mandalorian. This model is unique because it requires no support material, and I also printed it completely hollow. So the ribbon cables arrived in the mail, but I wanted the arm to have a little more movement, so I printed two more short extension arms. So pretty in the sky. After those were finished printing, I assembled the whole thing and secured it to the edge of the table. This model is actually designed to go on the frame of the printer, but I wanted a little more distance between the camera and the print, so that's why I secured it to the table. After that was set up, I could properly focus the camera and do another test print. Well, maybe that print fail was just because of the stabilization settings I was using. Perhaps if I keep the nozzle off to one side, that won't happen. So I was getting a bunch of print failures, and every time that would happen, the nozzle would be clogged afterwards. After quite a bit of troubleshooting, I realized that the fittings at either end of the Bowden tube were not acting the way they should. The tube seemed to be a little loose. So after a bit of research, I found out this is actually a common problem with the stock fittings on the CR10, so I just got those replaced and had the printer back up and running. Now one thing about making time lapses like this, the length of the video depends solely on the height of the model. The reason this can be confusing is, take for example this cube, which took an hour to print, but this one took 6 hours to print. Now I haven't printed anything with support yet. Let's change that, shall we? This model of the Halo 1 Magnum needs a little bit of support to print. Alrighty, for the last time lapse of this video, I wanted to print something that would look cool while it was printing, so I found this weird lattice model on Thingiverse and gave it a print. Alright, so overall this is a pretty cool addition to a 3D printer, but there's a bunch of other things I didn't cover, and they mainly have to do with things not related to making those cool time-lapse videos. Here's a quick list of all the extra plugins I installed. I also forgot to mention that I connected Kira directly to Octoprint, so I could print straight from the slicer now. No more saving things to SD cards or manually uploading G-code to Octoprint. Printing things is a super easy process. The whole setup works great. I really love being able to control and monitor the printer from any device, and I really like having that nice interface to interact with the printer on. And what's really great is the Raspberry Pi does all the work, so I could start a print from my computer and then completely turn it off, and it won't affect the printer whatsoever. And this whole setup is upgradable. I could have gotten a better webcam, I could add some better lights in the future, but for now, I think it's just what I need. This has brought us to the end of the video. Again, all of the resources I used are linked in the video description. Models, tutorials, program downloads, it's all there for you. I would recommend anyone who likes filming the 3D printer to at least consider making this upgrade, because it's really cool. Also, a fun little fact, I started 3D printing about 1 year ago when this channel had about 60 subscribers. Currently, there are 170 of you, and I want to say thank you for joining me on my 3D printing adventures. If you like this video, then be sure to hit the like button, and if you want to know when more videos like this are made, then be sure to hit subscribe. But for now, I'm Nathan, and I'll see you next time.